Hello everyone, welcome to the stream. I'm really happy to see you, and tonight we're going to be casting the 12th season of Alpha Team League. It is Euro Semi-Pro, and our boys from Wolfsire are facing their opponents from Team Supply Zero. The first match is going to be Symphonic versus Captain, and after that Mr. Symphonic will join me as a co-caster. So, hope you're happy with that. Hello, Kostas. Hi, Doom Cookie. Welcome everyone. Guess we're still waiting until the match, the map is created. Symphonic is already here. I hope you would give me some time to host our stream on another website to get more viewers, because our academy guys are so adorable that they should be known everywhere. Okay, hope it's working. Is it? Okay, so I guess no one is creating the map so far. By the way, as you are sitting there and watching the stream, don't forget to follow our Twitter. Okay, I guess I'm gonna create the first game. Wait. Jesus. Is it up yet? Wow, Nidix, thanks for hosting. Thanks a lot, dude. So, the first map should be Dreamcatcher. Oh wait, Token is already in the lobby. Wait. We're gonna join. Not gonna lose any single moment. Thanks for following. Okay, we can join the lobby. Wait, why is it a parasite? Okay, so apparently I'm gonna be. Okay, nice, amazing. Notice me, Senpai.
Hello?
Hello, Mr. Symphonic. How are you today?
I'm just fantastic. How are you?
Thanks. I'm very good as well. So I'm super hyped for today's Clan War. How are you? I mean, I know
I'm.
you're playing in it.
Yeah. Well, I was gonna separate my answers. I'm super hyped to cast. I'm halfway hyped to play. I'm scared.
Well, you know,
Shaking.
scared is not a good word for it. I would say enthusiastic should be a very good word.
Okay, I thought you were gonna say terrified, because I could
No,
say terrified. No.
terrified is a bad word either, so.
I'm terrified of my own power. I'm terrified of what I will do to them.
Okay, so Mr. Tripowoski is ready.
All right.
So I guess we're about to start. I'm gonna tell them that we're ready as well.
Okay. Just need an invite to the game there. Who's
Oh,
hosting?
wait. Can you do you have token in friends?
No.
Okay, add me.
Okay.
I'm gonna send you.
There we go. Okay, and I'll add you right now too. I just got the invite, but I'll add you as well.
Okay, I'm just gonna send you my battle tech. Token is playing poggers. Wow, Nidix is so hyped for Token. Yes, I guess everyone is ready. Everyone is here. And we're ready to cast the first match of today. It is gonna be Werner versus Tripolowski. It's gonna be PvT. Just wanted to remind that today's Clan War is part of Alpha Team League. So, hope you guys enjoy it as much as we do.
Yeah, really appreciate just having the opportunity to play in the league and a league that is quite well run, well managed.
So, thanks to Mayhem and all the admins who made this possible. Okay, so we're on Parasite, and in the bottom right corner, it is a Terran player representing Team Supply Zero. It is Tripolowski.
His opponent in the top left, representing Protoss and the Wolf Slayer team, it is Werner.
So, do you like PvT in general?
I play a rather unique style. I've got my own build that I like to use, and I don't mind the matchup. I know my Terran friends who play more standard are not big fans of it, but I think that as long as you can put some pressure on and dictate the pace of the matchup, I think Terran can do okay.
Because, well, Personally for me, PvT is one of the best matchups to both to play and to watch, because, you know, it just looks so nice. There is so much action in it.
Yeah, and I think actually in Legacy of the Void, it's a big improvement over Heart of the Swarm, which was pretty much kill Protoss before they get up to a late game death ball. You know, you pull the SCVs or use three ghosts for EMPs or whatever. But Legacy of the Void, like you said, it's full of action throughout the match.
Meanwhile, the second the second base of a Protoss is being blocked by an engineering bay. So that means that his second Nexus is going to be pretty delayed. So I don't even know what is the correct answer to those Terran actions.
Yeah, so he's got the Zealot on the way. That's going to start chewing away at the engineering bay. He'll be able to take that out. However, he does, Werner does have a probe heading down toward the bottom center portion of the map. We'll see if he wants to. Yep, he's going to throw it on a pylon, so it looks like he's going to put on some pressure.
Amen, I guess. That's a good idea. If you can't expand, just make your opponent pay for it. Meanwhile, the second CC is, I would say, one third done.
Yeah, the engineering bay, while it delays the Nexus for the Protoss, it does set behind your own expansion as Terran. And one more thing to keep in mind is that the SCV scout earlier did see two pylons up in the main of Werner, so he may not be aware that a proxy is in play. He actually sees the expansion as well, so we'll see if his scouting intel lets him know that there could be a proxy.
The problem is there is nothing so far on the main base of a Protoss player to remove this Reaper. That is being so annoying. This Reaper killed two probes. That's not very nice, I would say.
Yeah.
Losing too many probes in an early game might be very dangerous, I would say.
Yeah, this is actually getting to be significant damage now. A fifth probe is going to go down to a single Reaper. It looks like Werner may be able to kill it with this Stalker, but he definitely needs to get some damage done with this Oracle that's about to pop.
Okay, let's see if Triple Oski is ready for this Oracle. I wouldn't say so.
Yeah, at the moment, he's not in great shape. I mean, he has a Cyclone and a Bunker, so he shouldn't take game-ending damage to it. But at the same time, he's definitely going to lose a few SCVs if this is played correctly.
Okay, so I would say there is no way this Oracle gets to the main base, so maybe a Phoenix would help.
Yeah, it looks like he is going to queue up a Phoenix there. I'm a little bit surprised. I guess maybe probably a better choice once he saw the Cyclone to back off. But I thought he might press the issue a little bit more and pick off a few more SCVs before, get the Oracle down to red health and then leave, just because he did lose so many probes to that Reaper.
Well, there are already two Cyclones, one in a main base, the other on the natural, so
yeah, the opportunity is definitely passed. The Oracle's not going to, shouldn't be able to get any damage done anymore. I think he had that one window, and as soon as the Terran realizes that there's an Oracle out there, you shouldn't ever take damage to it again. From now on, it should just be revelations from here forward.
Okay, so there are already two Phoenixes and an Oracle. That's actually quite interesting, and the third Phoenix is on the way. Do you think it would try to put some pressure on Terran bases with those units?
Yeah, he might do. Just sort of poke in, see if he can get some SCVs building structures, things of that nature. Looks like that's what he's going to look for. Yeah. Of course, the priority here is just going to be, if he does decide to poke in there, he's got to keep all of these units alive. He doesn't have much of a gateway army beneath them yet, and he's going up to the robotics bay.
I guess so. The robotics bay. Would you say it's going to be disruptors?
You know, I was wondering that myself. I know as Terran, I have a lot more trouble playing against Disruptors, particularly when they're in high numbers, than playing against Colossi. I mean, Colossi are still good, but Disruptors, once you get up around like 5-6 Disruptors or so, you start facing perpetual Purification Nova. It's really, really difficult. So I would also say
that Disruptor is a unit that would help to turn a game that didn't start very successfully for a Protoss player.
Right. Really good point.
So Terran player is moving out with plus one attack and the steam pack almost finished.
And we see he's actually going to go for Colossi. Thermal Lance is not going to be done by the time this Terran army gets across the map. We'll see if he's able to buy any time.
So far it looks pretty bad for a Protoss player, to be honest.
The Stasis Ward. Yeah, he's got a couple of Stasis Wards. Maybe they'll hit. The scan misses them, but he might just dive on top of Werner's army here.
Okay, so Guardian Shield. Those Phoenixes try to snipe the Medivacs. The first Colossus is here. And, well, I guess this trade wasn't really bad.
Yeah, I think all things considered, it's been a great defense so far from Werner. Would like to see him keep that Phoenix alive, but regardless, he has the Colossus out now. Thermal Lance should be done pretty soon, and he's definitely going to be able to continue in the game.
So I would say a Terran player is going to try to attack from the both sides. So meanwhile, there is a double drop going right to the... I would say this double drop is going to hit the economy on the second base, but I might be wrong.
Yeah, I think he's even going to get a scout off on the third base. At the very least, may end up canceling it. Depends on the positioning of the main army.
And the main army is going to drop right on the main base. Oh my god.
Yep, no cancellation on the third, so that was an outright kill.
And that's a GG. I don't know, would you say it was too early for writing GG?
It may have been a bit early, to be honest. He was definitely in a difficult situation because his army was at the third base location with a double drop in the main, but yeah, maybe a little bit early.
Yeah, I mean, the Terran player didn't really have that much of an upgrade advantage or an army size advantage, so...
Yeah, I think maybe if he could have held on for a little bit, got out a couple of Colossi, you know, maybe he would have been able to threaten, but it's a good multi-pronged attack, though, I will say that, from Chipowowski.
Okay, so the first win goes to Captain. Oh, sorry, to Chipowowski.
Yeah, you just jinxed me, because I'm going to play Captain now.
Well, you know, in Russian tradition, it works the other way.
Okay.
So if I accidentally predicted you losing against Captain, that means that you 100% should win.
Oh, perfect. So, all right, I won't. I'll play with my eyes closed then. Here we go.
Oh my god.
It's
no.
Fate.
Well, good luck to you.
Thank you. Yeah, I'll leave the call and I'll just hop back on after my game.
Okay, sure. I'm gonna be waiting for you.
All right. Yeah. Well, hopefully it won't be too quick. I'll see you in a bit.
Okay. Good luck.
Thanks.
Okay, guys. Hope you are enjoying our Clan War so far. And Mr. Symphonic, my colleague, is gonna play right now. Okay, Werner, I hope you're not too upset, because, well, you know, there won't be any wins without any losers, so... And the next game is going to be on Dreamcatcher. It is going to be a TVT. And in the bottom right corner spawned Mr. Captain, a representative of Team Supply Zero, and an orange Terran. In the top left corner, it is a green Terran player representing Wolf Slayer Esports. It is Symphonic, also a great caster. Okay, so gas first from Symphonic, gas first from Mr. Captain. There is nothing unusual so far because gas first is the standard opening for most of the Terran players. Pidge, I'm sorry. I'm really, really sorry. By the way, shout out to all my Russian viewers. Hope you guys still enjoy. I wonder if it's gonna be standard bio versus bio, or maybe it's gonna be bio versus mag, because I don't know anything about the playstyle of our opponents. So Captain's SCV is here for scouting. Sees that nothing unusual is going on here. Meanwhile, Symphonic scouted as well. Sees is gonna block that second CC. That's very interesting. Okay, so wait. So Symphonic started his own CC. I would say the timing is even. So the first Reapers are already made for both of the players, right? Wait. Yeah. The second Reaper is following, so it's actually so good that Terrans have a unit that is good both for scouting and the early harass. Look at that. Both those Reapers are still here. That's quite interesting. Okay, here we see a first Cyclone being made. And Symphonic is gonna fly to a reactor. Actually, go Symphonic. Okay, guys, support our player, please. Symphonic is actually a little bit ahead in everything. He has more workers, he has a little bit more army. And the captain is going for a quick third CC. I guess Symphonic doesn't know anything about it. But maybe he can put some pressure on his opponent with those Cyclones. Or at least scout that third CC with his Reapers. The bunker is going down for Captain. Which means that he doesn't have any active plans on going out. There is a siege tank, and now the task of putting some pressure is becoming more and more difficult. There is gonna be a second tank pretty soon. Our captain scouts one more time, sees everything that is happening on Symphonic's main. He also scouts that third CC that is almost finished. Captain should be flying to the third base. with his first CC, but somehow he doesn't do that. So, according to the buildings and to the upgrades, both players are playing bio. Feda, the nickname of the guy who was commenting with me is Symphonic, and he's playing right now. So let's see what our players have. Symphonic just got his first tank. Has a couple of Marines, three Cyclones, and a first Viking. His team pack is gonna be just a little bit later, but he's gonna have combat shields. That's a nice Reaper duel here. Okay, so I find it a little bit funny that Symphonic's third base was actually later than the third base of his opponent, but he started mining before him. So. Symphonic already has a plus one attack, but the problem is he doesn't have that much army supply. But I wouldn't say it is a good idea to try to attack that army. Wait, how many tanks does he have? So he has three tanks. Two of them are here. The third one should be. Somewhere. I don't even know where it is, to be honest. Okay, so Captain is gonna attack Symphonic from the top right side, and he's gonna try to, for a second I thought that he's gonna try to drop. Those tanks are gonna get picked up. And now Captain only has one tank, but the problem is I don't see any tanks. Okay, there is a tank of Symphonic on the high ground. There is also one tank of Captain. And I guess Captain is gonna try to drop and take that tank. Okay, Symphonic procedures and is trying to pick this up. There is only one medivac left, so this trade was handled almost perfectly for Symphonic. He saved a couple of tanks while his opponent lost almost everything. There's gonna be a second wave coming. Guess Captain is gonna try to hit that 2-2 timing. Symphonic's 2-2 are gonna be a little bit later. The thing is, he has a liberator. Which, I mean, I don't even know if one liberator. Okay, a liberator and a Viking. That means he has some advantage in air fights. Captain's fourth base is already starting. And as I said, he's gonna try to hit that 2-2 timing with a push. Four tanks, some marines. I don't see any marauders here. There are a lot of medivacs. And he's gonna hit that fourth command center. Symphonic should be somewhere here. Already sieged. Okay, he's sieging now. Who's gonna hit the first shot? Very nice shot from the Liberator. Captain loses one tank. All five tanks of Symphonic are still here. Some SCVs who have been taken to this attack are actually killed, maybe? Okay, nice scan. There are too many tanks. Meanwhile, there is a drop on the third base. Six SCVs are killed. A couple of more die. And I don't really see the way. Okay. Jesus. That was just one medevac, right? So 15 SCVs killed. Symphonic is trying to resiege and take at least something, but his Liberator is getting killed. What is... okay, Symphonic is trying to do something with that siege. Sieging his tanks, he manages to clean it up. The problem is he lost the fourth base, while his opponent is already mining here. He also lost a number of workers, and his 3-3 upgrades are gonna be later. Just a little bit. But of course he has a lot of tanks. That's a very good start of a fight for our captain, as he caught the tanks in siege, but now he loses almost everything. There are only a couple of Vikings and some medevacs left. And Symphonic is keeping his tanks safe and sound. So what he has to do right now is try to attack the third base, because those tanks are sieged here. So that's actually very nice. He keeps making tanks. Symphonic's army advantage is quite big, I would say. He still traded better in this game. Okay, those marines team take a tank. There is one more tank. But it is unsieged. This Liberator isn't gonna finish. Oh, it is. And Symphonic is sieging again. I think he should take that. He's gonna kill that starport. There is no way that those marines can approach the tanks. Meanwhile, the Vikings are sniping the medevacs. But this game is already lost by Captain. There is nothing to defend. Well, there is a couple of marines here. In a second, Symphonic is gonna have 3-3 upgrades. So he's gonna trade even more effectively. Yeah, and it's GG. And Symphonic of Team Wolven makes the score equal. Hello.
Hello.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much. I'd like to say it was all my skill, but it was fate, as we discussed, so.
I would say it was still your skill.
Thank you.
By the way, the guys from a Russian website are very interested in your personality.
Oh, really?
Yes. They're like, what, who is that guy who's casting with you?
Oh, that's cool. Yeah, I actually speak Russian, so if they want to ask me questions, they can go for
it. Oh, really?
Yeah.
Well, that's unusual.
Yeah, it is pretty unusual. I agree. Hopefully they're asking questions in a good way, like not
yeah,
who is this loser who's casting
yes,
with Sky.
Yes, of course. They're like, well, who is that awesome guy?
Yes. I'm sure that's a direct translation, I bet. But thank you.
I believed in you.
I know you did. Yeah, I didn't, but you did. So thank you. I appreciate it. It's my worst matchup, and it's not my favorite map, so I wasn't sure how it would go, but turned out okay.
Well, people are pretty ambivalent towards Dreamcatcher.
Yeah, I think, most people say it's a Terran map, and I think it probably is. It's really good for drop play, but at the same time, I feel like there are so many counterattacks that are possible that it makes things chaotic sometimes, for me anyway.
Yeah, but still your tank count impressed me quite a lot.
Oh, well,
you have
thank you.
So many tanks. Jesus. Natix is writing in the chat, Symphonic Strong. I agree.
Symphonic Strong.
I agree.
Thank you. Thank you.
So,
if we're talking about my biceps, maybe, not my StarCraft play, though.
I bet he's talking about both. Okay, so the next game is going to be Token versus Nexus. Oh my god, that's going to be... Sorry, I shouldn't say that, I guess. But I just...
I like that, you have professional standards. Very nice, very classy, elegant.
Wow. Okay, so we're gonna watch a TVP on Fracture, and in the top left corner it is a red Terran representing Wolfslayer Esports. It is a guy from Poland, and his nickname is Token.
His opponent in the bottom right, wearing the teal trunks, representing the Supply Zero clan, he is Nexus.
And right now we're watching Nexus of a Nexus.
Indeed. Nexus is Nexus. Try saying that 5 times fast. No, don't. Don't try that.
So I just had a quick check on the opponent's MMR. And I would say Token is pretty much favored.
What are they? I wasn't able to check
well,
the time before.
I would say Token is 5.3, something like that. And his opponent is 4.7.
Okay, yeah, so it should be a comfortable
yeah.
advantage.
Yeah. I don't want to hype Token too much, or, you know, he's gonna be too proud of himself.
Because he has the opposite problem of me, then. I go in thinking there's no chance I can win. But Token apparently believes in his skill. I like that, though.
And then I would say that playing Clan Wars or even tournaments is a little bit, just a little bit more about your mindset than about your skill. Because, well, I can tell
yeah.
you a story of some 2v2 tournaments. On me and
yeah,
my,
hey,
when
if you
me
want
and my
to,
friend, on me and my friend almost won against Bratok and Demogo.
Oh my goodness.
Okay, a frame show just messaged. My dad won. Love you, Symphonic.
Yeah. Yeah, frame show is one of the. He's one of my longtime viewers from my stream, and one of my best friends in StarCraft. He helped me warm up today with some TBT practice. So.
Oh my god.
He's awesome.
Yeah, and then it's just. He's not really my dad. He's my sugar daddy. Come on, frame show. That's a little bit embarrassing.
No comment, no comment.
Okay, so Reverse here is gonna achieve pretty much nothing with that Stalker being in position. Rip the Reaper.
Yeah, rip the Reaper. I need to start using that. So the choice of tech is going to be Robo here for Nexus. Nothing too outrageous. We'll have to see if he wants to just go for an Observer. Maybe if he wants to go for an Immortal. A couple of different options, but as of right now, everything looks relatively standard.
Yeah, I mean, he plays a perfect standard in PvT.
Yeah, this is looking about as standard as it gets. There's going to be a short time here where the Stalkers will be annoying at the front until additional Marines come out.
That was actually pretty well microed by Nexus. It's gonna pick up an SCV, so now two SCVs are dead in total. Topple already has a mine, but...
Yeah, so you're pretty much at the mercy of the Protoss when both players are playing standard. Until the first factory unit comes out, usually the Terran has to be very cautious with those initial Marines due to like Stalker Adept or double Stalker pressure.
Okay, a very nice question in the chat. How happens your colleague speaks Russian? Is he genius or something?
Oh man, actually, I guess while we have some downtime, I can explain. I swear, guys. So actually, I originally wanted to learn Russian because I love Russian literature. So I wanted to read it in the original. From there, I ended up, when I was in university, I roomed with Russian roommates and ended up going to Moscow for an exchange program.
Wow.
Moscow State University for just a summer. And then since then, I take both my piano and my chess lessons in Russian. So yeah, it's been a number of years now. It's pretty much, I would say, pretty much like a second language for me. So.
And then probably we should cast something in Russian one day.
Yeah, that'd actually be cool. I've never actually spoken about the game in Russian. I'd have to learn some new vocab, but I think I can get it down eventually.
Okay, so a double drop with two mines is gonna get picked up. Actually, no. Thanks to boosts.
Yeah, thank you, David Kim. Loving that boost, baby.
And meanwhile, I remember how Sky maybe protested me with a Skytos rush in that free-for-all. I blew up half of her army with mines before leaving, and here we are today. Jesus. I don't remember that, dude. Sorry. I don't remember that. I mean, Skytos sounds pretty much like me, but... Okay.
Is that where the sky maybe comes from?
Actually, no. I just noticed that there is a frozen head tree here, some frozen Nidus worms on this map.
Oh yeah, the frozen Nidus looks really cool.
Yeah.
It's my favorite type of Nidus, the frozen one that doesn't let any units get out. So one thing that I am curious about here, and we probably will find out pretty soon, is if Tokon wants to hit a timing with the Stim and Combat Shields. This is, of course, a very short rush distance. He's going to scout that Nexus wants to take his third right now. So if he wants to hit that timing, he should be moving out any second now. The Combat Shield is about to finish up.
Yeah,
by the time he gets across, Stim will
finish. That was very unfortunate for Tokon, because his medevac got picked up, his Widowmine got picked up as well.
Yeah.
Well, at least he knows that there is a Nexus over here.
Yeah, I think the biggest loss from that is losing the medevac. The Widowmines at this point are, I guess, more, I don't want to say they're insignificant, but the tank and the bio is going to be the strength of this push here. It does look like he's gearing up for it. Yep, there he goes.
And this is how the life of that observer ended. Very dramatically.
Brutally, yeah. So he's also going to have plus one weapons with this as well. This is a very powerful attack. It's going to hit well before the 1-1 of Nexus, who's also trying to tech up to Templar Archives. He has two Colossi, though. So
yeah, and Colossi already have their upgrade. Wait, is he gonna drop to the main base?
It's a good question. He seems to be posturing for it, then unloads.
I would say that dropping to the main base would be a good option, actually. It could have been. Because... That is so painful. To be honest.
Yes, a very good fight. Good defense thus far for Nexus. If there's one positive that we can take away for the Terran, it's that he did scout that there were High Templar. Of course, they just used feedback. Storm is just starting now, but he knows what he's up against. He knows it's going to be the Gateway Colossus High Templar composition. We'll see if he wants to go for Ghosts in response or not.
Okay, so I guess Token would try to harass with those two Liberators, but the problem is there is a cannon here. So I would just go straight to the main base. But, wait. There is a shield battery here.
Yeah, I think the Liberators will still do fine. If it was a Banshee, the shield battery would shut them down really hard. But the Liberators, the Liberators don't care as much about the shield battery, so that should get some good damage done. It looks like Tokon is going to wait, maybe until he sees the main army, then he's going to run into the third.
Oh no, this army almost suicided themselves. But Token had a nice pickup. 10 probes are lost on that Liberator harass, so I guess Nexus didn't pay much attention to what was happening on his main base.
So the army is actually very scary for Nexus, however, he is down 13 workers, soon to be more. With this double drop in the natural, it's getting a lot of damage done here.
Okay, Token is able to save only half of his army because the second medevac got picked up.
Yeah, so all in all, just a couple of probes there, but also a High Templar and a medevac full of units did escape. However, Tokon is going to have to hold a very powerful push, which is setting up right outside of his third base right now.
I don't know
if he has the units.
Wait. I don't know either. Because a significant part of his army is in a drop right now, and he has to get it back.
Yeah, he's going to bring everything home. So he had 3 medevacs full of bio out on the map. He's going to bring all of it back now.
Meanwhile, 12 SCVs died in a storm. And those...
Good job kiting back with most of the bio. The storms didn't get too much done. It's going to come down to the Colossi now, though. I'm not sure if he has the units or not to take them out. They are pretty unprotected. This is not an easy position for Token at all. He lost a lot of SCVs there. He's down 13 workers now, and of course he's not mining off of his third just yet.
Well, I guess he's gonna put his third another mineral line, but I don't really know what he's gonna do with that siege here.
I just don't think that there's an answer right now for the 3 Colossi, not to mention the fact that more High Templar are being warped in, not too high on energy yet, but Token is not really in a position to break out of this containment. And while this is going on, Nexus is getting his 4th Nexus up.
Well, I guess so far he's trying to produce more Vikings to snipe those Colossi, but
did a good job of dodging the storms for the most part. He's going to try to hold on at the bunker. I don't know if he has enough. It's really, really close. I think the Colossi might just be a little bit too much, though.
He's making a good job sniping those Colossi. But there was a warp prism, and the last warping, I guess, makes Token lose this game.
Yeah. The Colossi are actually being rallied across the map now. Just a very, very small bio force in the main is not going to be enough to hold on. And I think Nexus has done it.
So it is. Two, one for supply depot, and the only possible way we can win this clan war is by playing ace, so we do need our fellow guy Soro to win over his opponent Noob.
Yeah, so by the way, in case you didn't know, Soro is actually Frame Show, so the guy from the chat, so he's Soro in battle.net.
Okay, I guess I would have to answer some questions in the chat. Mr. De Ville Turfet is asking why there is only Full HD 60 FPS quality available, and suggests that it might have something with an unreasonably high bitrate of the broadcast. Mister, I would like to say that 6K bitrate is pretty standard for such quality, and we have no influence over the algorithm that Twitch uses to define who to give access to changing the quality, so shouldn't really blame us. Okay, let's join.
I'm just I'm giving Frame Show a bit of a pep talk in the chat here, trying to get him pumped up for the game. No pressure. We just our life depends on him. That's all.
Hello, Mr. Zero Quality.
Oh, it looks like we have the wrong map. It's acid plant.
Yeah. I guess so. So can I ask you one more question about the summer you spent in Russia? Did you like it?
Yeah. Oh, I loved it. I loved it. I've got to say, it's a rather unpredictable and I would even say pretty aggressive environment in public. But at the same time, you know, I met a lot of people over there who were awesome, like really friendly people. Went to the banya. Like we had a shashlik, banya, jumped into the lake, all of that sort of stuff. It was so much fun. It was awesome.
Well, sounds pretty much like, Russian mentality to me.
Yeah. Yeah, it was fantastic. I definitely would love to return someday.
I wouldn't really say the environment is very aggressive. I would just say that we don't tend to share our we don't share too open to strangers.
Yeah, that's true. I guess what I mean is, so when I was there, I guess in public, for example, people seem to be more, it's not just, I wouldn't say cold or reserved, but there were definitely a lot of scenarios I saw in Moscow in particular. It wasn't so much anywhere else. It was really just Moscow, but quite unpleasant toward one another. Saw a lot of, I guess like fights and people almost getting into fights, stuff like that. But
okay, so
who knows?
An acid plant in the top left corner. It is Terran player representing Wolf Slayer Esports. It is Sorrow.
His opponent in the bottom right, hoping to close the game out for his clan, Supply Zero. He is the purple Protoss. It is Noob.
That's really funny. This nickname gives so many associations.
Yeah, exactly. So, I would like to pronounce it as like Nube, like sounding Spanish, Nube. But there's no accent. So I'm just gonna have to say Noob. Sorry, man.
Actually, yeah, I think Nube would sound nice. It would sound a little bit French, actually.
Agreed. Almost sounds like Russian, though, too, with like Lube.
Lube. I don't know. It doesn't really sound Russian to me.
No, it just reminded me of the group Lube, that's all.
Yeah.
Lube.
Yeah. Used to be pretty popular among the Russian patriots. So.
Yeah. Yep.
Look at that. Okay, that was pretty standard. For a second, I don't even know why, but like probably even for less than a second, I thought that it was a Nexus first. and then I realized there is a gateway. Yeah, that would be super greedy.
Yeah, very, very bold indeed. Especially, I think a lot of Terrans are playing aggressively, playing the matchup aggressively, it seems, especially in the Korean scene.
I mean, yeah, we've seen Korean playing in TVP a few days ago. TY versus Neeb. That was a quintessential of Korean playstyle, I would say. Thanks for supporting me, Fede.
So Reaper does get up into the main base, doesn't see much, just a stalker, and of course he saw the expansion, so no real information just yet for Sorrow. If I slip up and call him Frame Show, I apologize in advance. I'm just so used to calling him Frame Show, but I will try to call him Sorrow.
No, we have a couple of players in the Russian-speaking StarCraft scene that have two nicknames, and that might be very confusing.
Yeah, yeah.
You probably know Russian Protoss player Verdi, also known as Rail.
Yeah, I didn't know that he was also Rail though.
Yeah.
Yeah, Starro, he's a man of many nicknames, but his primary account had been Frame Show, and that's his Twitch name for a long time. But he doesn't want to make it easy on us. He has at least like three different names. But yeah, I'm gonna try my best just to call him Starro.
I'm sure I just thought of another Terran player who has a few nicknames. Ours, also known as Hades.
I see. No, I heard of Hades, but I didn't know that.
Well, Hades equals ours.
Okay. Nice positioning there, by the way, from Starro. He's able to pick off that Adept, deny some scouting. He's going to go for a second barracks behind this, so it looks like he's probably going to go for a Widowmine drop.
Yeah,
he might even press at the front. Four shield batteries, wow.
Four shield batteries, that's... that's radical.
Yeah, that really is. Now, granted, it'll make it hard to push there unless the pylon goes down, in which case the four shield batteries are nullified.
Okay. Let's welcome the Artosis pylon.
So Frameshow is going to poke at the natural with the Reaper and the Cyclone. He'll probably just run away. And he is going to boost the medevac with two Widow Mines into the main. Now
that was
we'll
a very good destruction.
Yeah. We'll see how quickly he can get this burrowed. Good job by both players there. Noob not losing anything in Frame Show. Also, not losing his Widow Mines, so probably just wait for another opportunity again when he can see where the main army is, and then send that medevac back in as soon as he ascertains the main army's location.
Well, I guess it's not bad that Noob lost some of that mining time.
Yeah.
So he had to pull the probes. Three stalkers are on the position. So.
Looks like Noob's setting up to take his third Nexus. Frame Show is on three barracks, but he's also going to start his third base now. Generally, you're going to want to push out, put some pressure. Usually, it's going to be at the third base of the Protoss while you take the third base behind. We'll see if that's what Frame Show has in mind here.
Well, I can certainly tell what Mr. Noob has in mind.
Go for it. Let's hear the prediction.
Actually, a second ago I was about to say that he's going to try to put some pressure on Starro with those talkers, but I guess he just changed his mind. He's getting back home. Look, there's a warp prism.
Yeah, I was just going to say, you might be right, though, with the warp prism. Looks like he's going to send that straight in there while he gets his third base. Frame Show, for his part, is just defending after losing his medevac and Widow Mines in the main. The one Widow Mine did fire, but it was on the probe that went into the assimilator, so no damage done.
An observer just got killed.
Yeah, good job denying vision there. It looks like that's going to cue Frame Show to head across the map now. We'll see where he wants to position this attack, if he wants to go up the main ramp in between all three bases. Scans ahead and sees the third base. He might catch a stalker. Looks like Noob does a good job of pulling away at the last second there. I think Noob actually F2'd though, because he's bringing that warp prism back when actually this is the time that he should be sending the warp prism into the main. Looks like he thinks better of it now and he's going to send the warp prism back. However, Frame Show is about to commence his attack here.
He has a vision to the high ground. pretty decent force field.
He's gonna start leapfrogging the tanks forward. There are a couple of shield batteries at the third, but if the tanks can cut off the reinforcement path, they might be able to get some damage done.
He's warping in some zealots. And a nice aggressive wing forward, picking up those tanks.
Looks like there are a lot of blink stalkers here. They're gonna take down one medevac. They might even get the retreating medevac. It's gonna be very close.
And Sorrow needs to get back, try to unite his armies, maybe. I don't know, that's a nice pickup of that Warp Prism.
Yeah, very nice indeed. It's, I've got to say, as a Terran player, it's really comforting when you can kill the Warp Prism. You know, okay, I've got about like 30 seconds to a minute where I don't have to worry about a Warp in of charge loss in my main.
RIP.
I just realized the double forges are only finishing up now, so it's a 1-1 versus 0-0 advantage for Sorrow.
And it's gonna stay the same for quite some time.
Yeah, hopefully I'd like to see him go into that 2-2 as quickly as possible so he can really maximize that upgrade advantage. However, Storm is just beginning now.
Most of the game, the economic situation was in favor of Sorrow, which I guess is not bad.
Yeah, I'll take that any day of the week. I think most Terrans are used to being behind in economy, usually behind in upgrades. It all depends on what the Protoss wants the Chrono Boost. So anytime you can be ahead in either of those departments, that's pretty nice.
Okay, so Sorrow scans, sees no fourth nexus.
Yeah, that's a really nice affirmation there for Sorrow. So he's going to push here, know that if he can't get into good position, he doesn't need to fully commit. He's not down a base or anything like that. However, if he can get damage done, so much the better.
That's a very good start of a fight for a Terran player, sorry. But
Excellent positioning. He's gonna take the Protoss down to two bases while having a 30 plus army supply advantage.
Jesus, those storms though.
Yep, the storms were good.
But Sorrow's army supply looks very impressive right now. Even though all
he's got a lot of healing power in the
medevac.
The medevacs, as President Trump might say, are very high energy. they're going to do a lot of healing, even though the bio was a bit low, but it's been revived to a significant degree. More storms are going to be cast. Sorrow does a good job of dodging them.
There are no more storms left, I believe. So Nirb is losing all his high templars, and that's GG. And it's 2-2, and we're up for the ace match.
Very well played there by Sorrow.
Okay, who do you think is gonna be our ace?
Who's deciding on the ace, by the way?
Well, I was about to ask you, what are your predictions?
Oh, well, my prediction and my hope is that it's not me. I think it's a safe prediction. Honestly, I think that Sorrow played very well in that game. I think he definitely could do it. I also think that Tokon definitely. I think he just had a bit of a rough game there, but I don't think he played anywhere near his usual level. So I think either of them could handle it, to be honest. What
Yeah,
about you?
so, well, I totally agree with you. So I would say we should expect a Terran player from Wolfslayer. Jesus, I'm rhyming things. Okay, I'm gonna be right back in like 2 minutes.
All right, sounds good.
Okay, so do you already know who's gonna be?
I think we're trying to figure it out. I think Tokon and Werner apparently don't. I don't think they're going to play, so I'm just checking with Sorrow right now.
Okay, Jesus. Okay, Sarah doesn't mind, I guess, right?
Sure, hope not. Okay, he said he doesn't mind. Great.
So our ace player is gonna be so. I'm gonna put that. Okay, so it's gonna be Sorrow versus Nexus. That's interesting.
So yeah, Nexus played, was it Token in his first match?
Yeah, and the map for the ace match is gonna be Cerulean Fall.
Okay.
Oh. Actually, I just checked Nexus stats statistics, and apparently PvT is his best matchup so far with the 60% win rate.
Yeah, that's pretty darn strong.
Yeah, but we've seen some solid TVP from Soro as well.
Yeah, definitely. Soro's positioning in the last game was really strong on his attacks. His macro never missed a beat. Hit his upgrades on time and everything. So definitely, I think it should be a pretty evenly matched game here.
Well, I hope so. All our hopes and prayers are with Soro now. Yeah. Alrighty.
Let's do it.
Oh, wait, I'm the host. Jesus. So it is Cerulean Fall, and in the top right corner it is a red Terran from Wolfslayer, and his nickname is Soro.
His opponent in the bottom left, he's our Protoss player, and in the teal, hoping to win this clan war for his clan, Supply Zero, it is Nexus.
Hello to everyone who just joined our stream. That's Kai Maybe. I'm casting with Mr. Symphonic.
It's been a pleasure thus far.
Oh, thanks a lot. I mean, I can say the same, so.
Honestly, can you?
I can, sure.
Okay. I'm gonna take your word for it. You won't deceive me.
Guess how Nexus goes for probe scouting. But
yeah, everything standard thus far.
There is not much to spot right here, right now.
It's like both players are going to prepare to expand. Nexus is expanding after Cybernetics Core. So safe standard play for both players thus far.
Yeah, second base also goes for a Terran player.
Reaper's able to kill the scouting probe. Soro just being extra safe getting a bunker. Actually, I don't mind that decision at all. We saw in the game against Token on Fracture. Now, granted, that's a much shorter rush distance, but we did see some two-stalker pressure that was able to kill a couple of Marines and I believe a couple of SCVs, so that won't be a factor in this game.
Yeah, so I guess Soro just decided to learn on the mistakes of the others instead of his own mistakes. There is a very nice proverb about that in Russian language.
Are you able to say it in Russian, or are we doing an English-only thing here?
Дураки учатся на своих ошибках, а умные на чужих.
Uh-huh. I like that one a lot.
Well, I guess it is partly true.
Yeah, I'd say so. That's why I prefer to sit back and watch everybody else, so I can learn from their mistakes. And you know, I end up not making any kappa.
Oh, really?
Yeah, right. So Frameshow just, or I'm sorry, Sorrow. I'm gonna keep saying that. I apologize. Sorrow is going to go with the two barracks, factory.
And I guess
guessing will probably have the starport.
Yeah, and I guess Nexus is playing pretty much the same as played in a game versus Token. I see two gates so far, and the blink is almost halfway done. Robo goes down for Nexus.
What do you think about the Robo facility positioning there? I guess as a Terran, I know I would definitely send a drop past that at one point. The question is, you know, will it be picked off?
I'm pretty sure that this pilot and this robotics facility are here to spot the incoming drops.
Yeah, no, you know, we'll see if it ends up coming into play or not. I just feel like it seems to be maybe a bit too important to use to spot, but I mean, who knows? May end up being irrelevant, but I know that, again, as a Terran, if I see that an important structure like that, and I'm going with drop-heavy play, I'm definitely going to try to target it.
Yeah, and the thing is, they can turn off the power not only for this robotics facility, but also for those two gateways.
Yeah.
And it might be very important if you're going to trade the army.
So do you think, are we going to see an aggressive build here from Nexus? The reason I ask is because he's adding on a lot of gateways. He's got four gateways in production.
Yeah, that's going to be 9 in total, right? And most of the army of Sorrow is off for a double drop. Wait. This can... If Sorrow can hold this with... I don't really know. There is only one bunker. No.
Yeah.
Tanks.
This is going to be a difficult. Oh, wow. He's actually forcing a recall.
Oh, that's actually
really big.
Yeah, no. He can just pick up his army and go away. I guess he tries to trade his army for Stalkers. Oh, okay.
So that actually worked out, I think, as well as possible for Sorrow. I was actually really worried if Nexus would have pushed in there. There wasn't much army at home at all.
I mean, with 9 gateways, he could have just warped in if it wasn't supply blocked. So I don't really think it was a very good decision from Nexus. I would just attack that bunker, because there was nothing except for that bunker.
Able to get a cancellation on the third Nexus as well. I mean, this is going very, very well for Sorrow right now. There is the warp prism on the other side of the map. It's going to head into the main. However, there's a substantial amount of Marines there at the natural, so we'll see how quickly Sorrow can respond to this.
And it's gonna take a lot of time for... I guess Nexus wouldn't go for denying those two upgrades. He's gonna try to... He's shading right onto the economy, but those adepts are gonna get killed pretty fast.
Yeah, only 4 workers killed there, so...
So, I guess you trade 4 adepts for SCVs. Not a good trade at all.
Yeah, not at all. Definitely favors our Terran player here.
Economy-wise, those players are pretty even right now. But it is so before Sorrow throws mules, can actually open the income advantage graphics and see how his income advantage rises up to the skies.
So Sorrow is definitely in a good shape here. He's got 1-1 against 0-0. 2-2 is on the way. He's 6 workers ahead, and he's ahead in army supply. So he's got every advantage possible. The only caveat is that the Templar Archives is finished, so Storm is always sort of a wild card. With that being said, Sorrow does have a Ghost Academy complete too, though.
I don't know. Would you like Sorrow to have more tanks?
Yeah, there are a lot of Charge Lots and Archons out there, in a, as well as two Immortals. So this is going to be a powerful push. The upgrade advantage, of course, again, is in Sorrow's favor. But, I mean,
but
that's a lot of Protoss.
But those tanks are not staged. The beginning of the fight is very successful for a Protoss player.
The third base is looking like it's going to be sacrificed. I don't think there's any way that Sorrow can hold on to that. This game started so well for him, but just not being sieged up and ready to defend may have cost him here.
Do you think there is any way for Sorrow to hold that?
It's going to be tough. If he has a chance, it's going to be if he can fight at 2-2 against plus 1 attack, and if he gets some good EMPs off. He doesn't have much splash damage. He's got one tank, so no Widow Mines, only that one tank. But, I mean, his army supply is okay, and with the upgrade advantage, he might, if he can get an army-on-army engagement under those circumstances that I described, he may be able to pull himself back into it, but definitely an uphill battle for sure. Beautiful EMPs to start the fight, though. Once again, the tank isn't sieged. It may come back to bite Sorrow. While this is going on, there are charge lots in the main, killing the SCVs at the mineral line. Nexus, I think, may have broken our Terran player. It's a very, very close game.
GG
is called. There's a very close game until that attack where the tanks weren't sieged up. Sorrow was just not ready, and Nexus was able to do that critical damage.
That's pretty unfortunate. Anyway, congratulations to our opponents.
Yeah, congratulations to Supply Zero. Well played.
Okay, so I guess that's all for tonight.
Yep, thanks for having me for the co-cast. I enjoyed it, and thanks everyone for watching as well. Hope you guys had fun.
Yeah, okay, so one last question in the chat to answer. Mr. Fedosumkin is asking where you are from.
So, I'm from the US, from the state of Pennsylvania.
Okay, so hope you're satisfied, Fede. Anyway, good night, everyone. Don't forget to follow our channel. Don't forget to follow our Twitter as well. And maybe see you next time or one of the next times. Knows?
Yep. Thanks for watching, everybody.
Thanks
we'll catch
for
you next
watching.
Time.
Goodbye. Thank you.
Your God.